Hi guys, great to have you in this tutorial that we are going to talk about variant properties, that these are actually custom properties that we can create to our components beside the given ones that we can create that Figma already gave us. So let's say if I select this component and I hit the plus, you will see that we have here these three properties that I'm assuming you're already familiar with. If you're not, I have a tutorial about component properties which will make it more clear and make you give you more knowledge about it. So I strongly suggest that you will see it if you don't know what are properties at all. And the fourth option actually is the variant property, meaning that when I click on that, I'm creating another custom property. It's not to create another variant. Let's kind of like remind for a sec. If I select the Boolean property, I'm calling it icon, and I can just apply it to all these layers in these variants that I've created here already. Okay, I can create actually the property and then apply it to different layers in our components. So I can select these three and actually from here, from the layer, here I have the button to apply the Boolean property. I can just click on it. I'm gonna select the one which I called actually an icon. And now, as you see, in this component, we have a switcher on off, so we can switch it off and then hide the icon and switch it on and see it. So that's basically what it does. And you can also, of course, if that was a component, you can apply an instant swap to it, a text to this one, to the text, of course, a text, a content property, and so on. Yeah, okay. And now let's say that I want to have another version of these three buttons, but with a stroke. A stroke is a design property. Okay, it's not a technical property. So I can't do that with these properties as you see here, these three. So I'm gonna create, let's say, a stroke property. Stroke, I'm just gonna call it a stroke for now and just leave it there, create the property, and I'm not doing anything with it at this moment. I'm just gonna make this frame bigger, select these three buttons, and I will duplicate them to have another three variants. Now, the variant properties actually are properties that are presented and applied on variants. They will be actually applied by variants. Okay, so let me explain exactly how I do that. So the trick here, if I want to create an on-off property, okay, kind of like a toggle, not kind, but actually a toggle that I can switch something on and off. So I need to give these two the same name. You will see the trick. Now, this is white and I will call this one. Oh, that's also white, which is great. It's giving me, you know, sometimes it doesn't copy with the same name. Anyway, doesn't matter. This one, light blue, great, and light orange, great. Now, you see this message which actually tells me that I have more than one variant with the same name, meaning that it can't really work as a variant. So that's okay, because this is exactly what I wanted for now. That shows me that I'm on the right way. Anyway, I'm gonna select these three buttons and apply a stroke to it, because this is exactly what I wanted to show. Now, I will select these three buttons again, and on the stroke property, the custom property that I have created, I'm gonna write no. Sorry, yes, because these ones has a stroke. So I'm gonna just write yes. The toggle on-off properties can work with yes, no, true, false, on-off. So that's the way that it technically works. And on these three, I'm gonna select these three, and I'm gonna write here no. That's it. Practically speaking, this is the whole trick, and this is how you create it. So now you will see that our cute button here has a switch of a stroke, and when I hit it on, I'm gonna see the button with a stroke. I can also change the colors because I gave each one of them these two variants, with a stroke and without a stroke. Okay, And of course change to this one. I can switch the icon off because it's still a property that we gave before, a Boolean property. And I can also switch this one on and off, and that works perfectly. So that was one example of doing it. Here I have a bottom navigation bar with these three icons. Actually, this one, yeah, it shouldn't be missing variant. Yeah, because I tried it before, but anyway, it doesn't matter. So I'm gonna just, let's say, copy. Yeah, this is the outcome basically, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, I'm gonna just paste to replace, and that's about it. Okay, I'm gonna create these actually variants to them, meaning the selected version of them that we can switch on and off. So I'm gonna make this frame bigger. I'm gonna do the same. I'm gonna just take these icons and duplicate them exactly as I did with the buttons. Okay, now this one, yeah, you see here now it didn't give them the, I think it's because I gave the property before, that's why, but it doesn't matter. I'm gonna do it just quickly, profile, copy, and I'm gonna give this one the same name, and five, I'm gonna do it really quickly, and yeah, I'm gonna see that video. Yeah, okay, good. So that shows me that I'm on the right way. Settings. Exactly. Okay, good. Now I'm gonna give them actually the design that I want. Okay, I'm gonna just select all these ones, the vectors inside these frames, and I'm going to give them a black color. And the other thing that I want to do is actually give it kind of like a circle that shows that they are selected, something like that. I'm gonna put it in here. Yes, exactly. And I'm gonna give it kind of like a red color, something like that, which is good. And as you see, the clip content is not on, so I can see this circle outside of the frame, but of course it still belongs to it. If I'll hit the clip content, then it's gonna be hidden. So I'm gonna leave it like that, which is good. I'm gonna copy it, select all these three, and just paste it. And it's gonna be pasted in each one of these frames at the same place, which is good. I'm gonna take it maybe just a click, one click or two down. Yeah, something like that. That is good. Okay, now actually I'm going to create the property to this component, which I'm gonna call this property, it's a variant property, and I'm gonna call it selected. Selected, and I'm gonna create this property. Good. And now I will do exactly the same. So I'm gonna select these four, and I'm gonna give them a true. It's the same as giving them a yes, I'm just showing it in another way. And these four, I'm gonna write here false. So basically what I have now is each one of them have its own selected state, which is great. So that is the type of it. This is favorite, selected, I hit it on, and then I see the selected state of this icon, which is great actually. This one is a bit too big maybe, but never mind, you get the general idea. It doesn't matter now, design wise we have done it to work. And of course you can just even do variants on this bottom navigation bar. So here you're gonna have the profile, you're gonna have this one, we're gonna switch it off, and then you can do like different versions of it with selected states and use it through different screens. So practically speaking, I think that this is pretty much it. I mean, you get the general idea. And if you create another property which is presented by not a switcher of an on-off, so you can do just a list property exactly as we have here with these colors. I mean, this one actually is also a property. It's a color property and it has three colors in it. So that is a list. Of course, if it's more than two options, or it can be also, by the way, only one property. It doesn't need to have options, but the minute that you do add a property, you need to refer to this property in each one of these variants, okay? Like if I want to add here actually a shadow property. So if I want to add, by the way, to have buttons with a stroke and a shadow, okay, not saying that I will do that, but sometimes maybe yes, if I want, then I will have to add another version with a stroke and a shadow together. Meaning, just wanted to sharpen this point. Let's say that if I take this one, okay, and create another duplication of these ones here. So I want to apply to them, let's say, a shadow. So if I'm creating another, let's give it a variant shadow. Okay, shadow. And now I'm going to apply, I'm going to apply actually a shadow to all of them, because that's what we wanted to create. So let's give them an effect. Yeah, these colors, they don't look amazing with a shadow actually. So, but anyway, yeah, design wise, it's not really one of the greatest choices, but anyway, let's make it a bit nicer. Let's give it a kind of a 20 and something like that. Put the blur on it a bit bigger. Yeah, let's say it's looking kind of okay, not more than that, but anyway. So yeah, that's okay. A shadow, so we give it a yes. And here all these, so now look at all these six, actually I need to refer to this property somehow if I want to make it a switch of an on off. Meaning all these six I need to select and give them on the shadow no. Okay, and now it will work like that. But you will see that I can have either a shadow or a stroke, because if I'll hit the shadow on, you will see that the stroke will be switched off because it's in another variant. So when I switch it on, you see this one switches off. So I cannot kind of like hit the stroke on and the shadow on, and have a stroke and a shadow together. No, I can't do that. I mean, it doesn't work like that. Meaning if I want another version of a shadow and a stroke together, then I will have to create another set of variants with a shadow and a stroke. Okay, so it cannot kind of like combine properties from different variants and just switch them on and off, and you will have it either way you want. You have to create. That's why I said, by the way, that each property is presented by a variant, meaning it cannot just be out of the blue you're gonna have a shadow and a stroke. Of course that I mean that in general. I'm just talking about these two properties, but it can be any design property, any one of them. Okay, it's just an example of it. So anyway, I hope that is understood enough, and basically these are variant properties. Remember, you can create any custom property that you want to your component. Okay, so I would be very happy for your like if you did like this tutorial, and subscribe to the channel. It helps to maintain it and to grow it, and I am very happy for each new subscriber, and of course a like that I'm getting, and really it helps to support the channel. So please do, if you are, I will be very grateful. And any question, just write to me, I will answer. Any tutorial that you want me to make, just let me know. Thanks a lot, guys, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye for now.